Okay, here's what's important today. I'm fishing somewhat, I'd say 90% of the time, 4 feet and less, and I want a reaction strike. So a lot of times you see me using the lighter weights and stuff if fish are moody, less aggressive and stuff, but I want them to be triggered into striking. So I'll use that little 3/8 ounce tour grade tungsten by striking. You know, small profile tungsten, it's like diamond, real tough, real light, small. But the deal is, normally, you see me throwing like 3/16 and stuff like that. So when it goes through the water column, all the way, they can have a look and maybe turn and eat it and stuff. Not today. I'm using the 3/8, heavier, falls a little bit quicker, but I'm not fishing in real mucky, gravelly, silted bottom and stuff where they can't find the bait on the bottom. But most times these fish, before it even hits the bottom, if they're on the edge of the pads, on the logs and trees like that, as soon as it pitches, they know. Their senses are so in tune with nature. As soon as something falls in the water, boom, they look, over they come, they can swim pretty fast. So the 3/8 ounce tungsten is way to go today. Like that one. He's a bit better. I wanna come in a boat, huh? You see, Mr. Chameleon, look at you fight, eh? Ready, swing, and a miss. Nope, no miss it there. It's getting a little bit better. Still not El Giento, but they're eating a chameleon bug. Whoa, whoa, whoa. Look at that penetration. You see that right there? There's no way he's coming out of there, boy. No way. Get him out. Again, beautiful bass, but not what I'm looking for. He is not picture worthy. Look at, but look at the length on him. He could be big one day. Look at the back. Beautiful example of Ontario largemouth. Let's put him right back, hey? Ready, boy? Look at that mouth on you, eh? Gone, but not forgotten. This is unreal, man. One little cove, but it's got everything perfect. It's got a creek coming out, pads going from 2 feet to 3, 4, 5, 6. Then it's got scattered pads, thick pads. It's got a beaver house in the middle of the thing. You talk about a haven for hogs. I see 2 5-pounders just swimming around, another 4-pounder. We catch a 3-pounder on the beaver house. This is the kind of spots you better put into your Garmin, because you come back later in the day, 2 hours later, 4 hours later, all day long. Remember, big fish move. When there's something that doesn't come into their place where they want to eat, there's a reason how they get big and stay big. They get fat because they eat. And if the food doesn't come to them, they go look for it. You keep going back to these kind of spots like this, you will catch them. Shocked if I don't get one in here. This is nuts. Oh, Lordy. Knew you had to be one of you. Good ones in here. Oh, yeah. Yes. Hey, ready to come in? Oh, God, hey. That's what I was talking about right there. That's what the chameleon does. Look at the chameleon in his mouth. Oh, thank you, Lord. Thank you. Look at that. Hey, how's that for a nice Ontario largemouth? Pushing 4 pounds. Just coming out of those pads. I just finished saying there's too much good water. You're going to go for a swim with your girlfriend, okay? What do you think? You happy? Don't worry, I'm gonna hurt you. But you saw that chameleon rage bug and you had to eat it. I saw you come out too. Beautiful bass, eh? Look at that. Nice and thick. Let's put her in with a girlfriend. I'll show you again, man, exactly what this deal is. Chameleon bug. Strike King, made by Steve Parks. And I got it on that little 4-rod extra wide gap. All the way down. This, I got that little 3/8 tungsten tour grade. I want it to fall fast. I want a reaction bite. I want them to look at it. I want them just to eat it. That's the setup right there. Simple as sin. But using the brand new St. Croix Legend X. I saw that fish come out and just barely felt it. Think about how many times you're pitching along, going along, and you feel something a little bit weird, eh? I saw it and I still barely felt it with one of the best rods on earth. You feel something, see something, hit it. Let's go.